Good evening, friends. So I think now, since we have started the day in the afternoon, I think all of you have got excited about the digital transformation. Again, as I said, what got us here won't get us there. So is digital transformation required? I don't think that's a question in any one of our minds. And again, how do we do it? I think we have covered it during our first few sessions. So till now, whatever we have seen is that, you know, what are the technologies available, how can we make it happen, how others have done it, what are the lessons learned, what to do, what not to do. So I think you've really got a good glimpse of all of it. And you know, we all being technology experts, for us to really manage digital technologies, I think I would say comes naturally. What I'm going to talk about is the culture part of it. How do we create a culture of digital innovation? Before we start, okay, I'll just briefly introduce myself. I am Viral Gandhi. I am the group CIO for Piramal. So in Piramal, we have multiple sectors. We are into pharma, we are into manufacturing, we are into financial services, we are into real estate. All the different sectors in the different stages of the journey, all of them kind of, you know, moving towards the digital transformation and managing the culture in each of the sectors on the digital journey. You can understand how challenging it would be. So my idea today is that, you know, just to share some things from my experiences and some things which I have learned recently in my education program. So I'll just talk about that. This doesn't work. Sorry. Yeah. Can you change it for me? You want to change it? Okay, fine. Sorry for the technology disruption. So as you said, digital transformation is not about a technological shift. In fact, technological shift, all of us can, you know, really do it very well. It is a shift in the organization's mindset and culture. And that is the critical part. In fact, you know, at Piramal, we say that, you know, changing, getting technology ready for business is what we are, what takes away 50% of our energies. But 50% of energies go into getting business ready for technology. And that's where I talk about the culture part. So this is like, you know, our approach at digital transformation. I think I'm putting the whole journey. How do we create a digital vision? How do you really benchmark the maturity of your organization? How do you define your priorities? How do you create a roadmap? How do you define your footprints and, you know, and put a proper governance in place, create a cultural change program, and then establish the innovation plan. So out of that entire journey, what I'm going to talk about is primarily the cultural change part. Can you move on, please? Again, you know, you all would be familiar with the famous statement that culture eats strategy for breakfast, which Peter Drucker says. So you can have everything in place, but if the culture is not managed, it can easily collapse, it can easily fail. How do you define the organization culture? The traditional way was that, you know, what do you mean by culture is the way we behave around here, okay? So how do we behave in our organization, in our family, in our society? That's what defines the culture. However, in today's context and in the context of digital transformation, the definition of culture is little expanded further. The way we behave around here, supported by rewards and consequences, and that are transparent and fairly distributed. And that's what kind of, you know, applies to all of us in the digital transformation journey in the organization culture. So if I have to split the organization culture into some key components, okay, these are the four components the way I kind of have learned it recently, okay, is our shared beliefs. It is very important that, you know, the entire organization has a shared belief what the transformation can do it for us and what transformation cannot do it for us. If it can do it for us, then no, would we have patience for that? Would we have would we compromise the transition period which we'll have? So that shared belief within the entire organization is very, very important. And as a leader of the transformation journey, it is our duty to really create that shared beliefs. The next is articulated values. So when you get into this transformation journey, okay, it is very important that we articulate the values which we are going to all behave, show in our journeys. Again, for transformation, what are the values which you would have? Very important that we define it first and articulate to the entire organization. That's the responsibility of a leader. And then our normative behaviors. So how do we behave? Are we demonstrating through our behavior the shared beliefs? Are we demonstrating through our behavior the articulated values? That's very, very important. See, we all know that in the digital transformations, everybody says, okay, that fail fast and learn from it and move forward. Are we showing the behavior of accepting failures? So many times what happens that we tell people that yes, we know the digital transformation methodology and all, I think failures are going to happen, but when a failure happens, are we accepting it? Are we showing that in our behavior? That's is critical. And again then rewards and consequences. So it is very important that we in our culture we define it very clearly that what behaviors we are going to reward, what outcomes we are going to reward. And it may not be, again, in fact, in one of the organizations, one of the leading organizations, what they have done, they have come up with an award for failure. So if all the POCs, all the proof of concepts which have been done and have failed, they all nominate for that. And then based on the right approach which you have used, okay, even if you have failed, you get awarded. So it has to come out in our rewards and consequences. In fact, just these four components which I see as key to the organization culture, if I use my science, mathematical lens, how do I define it? Okay. So I define it as organization culture is shared beliefs plus articulated values, and my behavior, how do I demonstrate those two, and which results into rewards and consequences. So this is what is very, very critical for us to achieve the organization culture. Again, this slide is not mine, it comes from MIT. Also, there is a theory about glue and grease. Okay, I think this is a very common theory, okay, that in our if we want to establish a healthy culture, the glue and grease plays a very important role. The glue which binds us together. So if we all come together for a shared belief, shared values, okay, I think that will help us achieve our vision. And again, grease enables the innovation, fresh thinking, resiliency. So that's the characteristic of grease which helps us in our healthy culture. And again, if you see exactly opposite, if you have an unhealthy culture, again, those same glues and grease can impact you negatively. So overall, glue can again keep us stuck to the past. We may not be ready for the change. We may want to continue the traditional way which we have been operating for many, many years. Okay. And same way, grease can help, grease can be a hindrance by making us slip and fall the way we on a journey. So I think that's just a corollary to give you an idea that what kind of behaviors, what kind of attributes are critical for a healthy culture, and how do we avoid the attributes and behaviors of unhealthy culture. So I think it's a very good statement, so hence I put it. The paradox of cultural change is that, while everyone says, yes, we want to change, So today if I put you here a question that who wants to change, so I'll definitely, I can see that all the hands will come up. Okay. But the fact is that, in our actual behavior and actual day-to-day thing, we don't really like the change. Okay, and if we have to lead the change, okay, we would be the last person. Okay, we would always resist. So as a leader, I'm here with the technology leaders of various organizations. As a leader, we're expected to lead the technology transformations. So how do we really make that happen? So here I would like to share some of the things, culture hack, okay, what all things you do. So think big, very, very critical. I think we saw the 1%, that it's not about the cost savings. It is the 1%, again, you know, same thing like in our case, in our pyramid glass manufacturing, 1% improvement in efficiency results into crores and crores of rupees of savings. So how do you really think big? Again, start small, fail, learn, and scale fast. Push, but don't pull. The attitude has to be from know it all to learn it all. In fact, you know, recently I came across the statement which Satya Nadella said, okay, that we are a learning organization. Okay. So if you know, if Satya Nadella at the helm of Microsoft, he can say that, okay, I think it all applies to all of us also, that we have to have an attitude of learn it all. And then short wins. Again, this also is part of a culture that when I'm doing digital transformation, I will do a lot of POCs. Even if I have an interim milestone which I have succeeded, even if I have succeeded in a POC, how do I celebrate that win? How do I encourage people for that win, which excites the entire organization? In fact, communicating a success of a small POC also goes a long way, because you are really giving vision to the entire organization that yes, we can do it, and we have it as a small POC, but it creates a demonstrative effect. So in today's time, in our digital transformation journey, these are the key components of culture hack, the way I see it. I'll talk about pyramids, okay, I've not put everything in detail, but I kind of talked about the complexity of the culture. Again, we have a manufacturing business, so whatever we discuss in the panel, you know, before my session, and again we are going to discuss after my session in the pharma, how are we going to do it. So we have kind of, you know, tried our hands to it, okay, we have failed sometimes, we have succeeded sometimes, but I'll just share some of the things which have worked for us. Okay, what we have done is, you know, we have launched a platform called Pyramid Tech Fest. We felt that it is important for us to really excite every employee about the technology. Okay, every employee, they should feel that yes, technology is the future, and I can do it, and I want to do it, and that's the level of excitement needs to be done at every level, starting from every employee to the middle management to the business leaders. We also taken a few initiatives where we take our business leaders out. We take them out of the organization. We take them to the executive briefing centers of the technology stalwarts. We take them out for startups. You know, we take them out to competitors, okay, just to see where they have kind of leveraged the technology for their business advantage. We also demonstrate to them that how the business KPIs can be achieved through this new technologies which are kind of, you know, coming up. Also, I think for our entire technology team, how do we make them current? How do we make them futuristic? Again, you know, very important. Very, very often we all get into you know, a mode where, oh, I have learned for my entire life and I want to share that, I want to leverage that, and you know, eat on whatever I've learned for my rest of my life. And that generally doesn't work. So it is important to create a culture of learning. Every employee within our IT should be kind of, you know, clear that, you know, whatever I've learned is a good base, but I need to continuously learn. And that's where we've launched an IT Academy, where every employee every year is supposed to learn X hours of new technology. Okay, and that's kind of, you know, the platform which we have launched, and you know, when we are strictly monitoring and measuring it. And then design thinking, everything what we do. We saw today's time, you don't sell product, you sell the service. We talked about the case of tire, where your people were selling tires and now they sell tire as a service. Likewise, okay, we are not selling bulb, we are selling lights. That's where the design thinking plays a big role. That, you know, maybe traditionally I was operating in a particular model, especially if I look at our manufacturing business or if I look at our pharma business, primarily they are in B2B. And when you are in B2B, you probably don't think about the end consumer, you don't think about the end customer. But it is very important that, you know, now with the design thinking approach, we every time trying to think that, you know, what is that, okay, what is the end consumer needs, and how do we tie it back to our product, how do we tie it back to our service. And that's kind of, you know, is one of our key aspects of our cultural hack. Okay. And likewise, there are many, many such initiatives. Okay, in the interest of time, I'll not go further detail. These are some of the digital initiatives which we have implemented successfully across our various sectors. RPA has been a big success for us. Okay, it has really shown good results. Chatbots, we are in the early stage, and we see that yes, it is working. In our B2B business, the suppliers kind of, you know, would like to use it in you know, instead of really calling people. RTMI has been a big success. In fact, Indian Express and Express Computers covered a detailed article about what we have done in manufacturing through RTMI in our glass business, managing from cold end to hot end, you know, and how do we really improve the efficiency there. Overall, the analytics piece, you know, how are we capturing all the data and how are we analyzing all the data and how are we taking real-time decisions based on the data, kind of we have been able to do it. And we are also making our hands, with augmented reality and virtual reality. So that's in nutshell our journey. Again, it is never too late to start on the journey, and for all of us, very, very important to focus on the culture. I think technologies, we all will be able to do it, okay. But it only takes care of 50% of what we want to do. The rest 50% in my mind is culture, culture, and culture. I think with that, I conclude my speech. If you have time, I can take up questions.
So we'll take a maximum of 2 questions. Yeah, I've got 2 questions from that table.
Actually, can you please switch to the previous last slide? Yes. So, can you please little bit explain the RTMI concept you have implemented?
So, under RTMI, what we have done? Okay, again, you know, I think I'll just try to give you a little brief, and we can discuss at length in detail. Okay. So, in our case, okay, the glass manufacturing, how it happens that, you know, you have a furnace, okay, in which you put the old kind of, you know, glass cullets and, you know, and the sand and other material, and then from there the entire manufacturing, you start with the hot end, you know, where the glass bottles are manufactured, and then it passes through the quality, and then it again goes to the hot cold end, and then again quality check. So in the whole process, what we have done first is that, you know, overall we have put the sensors at all the ends, okay, and we are in the whole process, there are multiple parameters which determine the efficiency of the process. And what happens that, you know, again, our efficiency straight impacts the wastage and the cost. So what we have done is that, you know, now with that efficiency, we have previously, what used to happen that we would get the reports at the end of the day and would see, yes, okay, what was the efficiency of each batch, and then we realize it and maybe we try to correct it next time. So now what happens that, you know, there is this entire RTMI process is completely real time automated, and, you know, even sitting here I can connect to my RTMI and I can check each batch. What is the efficiency? How are the parameters at every point in the process? And if I see that some parameters are not right, okay, I need to maybe the temperature in the furnace, I need to increase it a little bit or reduce it a little bit, or my mixture portion, if I need to change, whatever I need to change in the whole process, it real time tells me that yes, my efficiency has gone down because of this, and I can immediately correct it. So the within the batch processing itself, I'm able to correct it. So that real time decision making helps improve the efficiency, and that's what we have done it as of now for the manufacturing line. We are extending this to make it more ops insights, so entire operation process insights, and we are also taking it forward for our energy consumption. So for us, energy is a significant cost. So we already started a POC on energy management through IoT.
I'm Vichy here from SLR. A great presentation. Could you elaborate on how did you start the discussion on the cultural change? Was it you who initiated it, took it to the business leaders, and then it percolated, or it happened in a different way?
So I think we discussed that, you know, the approach which we take, whether it's top down or bottom down, okay, bottoms up, okay. In the culture, it has to be top down. Okay, you can't really change the culture of the organization from bottoms up. Okay, so definitely, again, as an organization, at Piramal, we have been successful in the business for so many years, and we have, you know, our key values are innovation, entrepreneurship, and we have tried different things. Okay, while the digital transformation, we picked it up for the first time, but we know that any change which we need to bring, okay, the culture has to be tackled. So if I, before we started our technology journey, when we did our quality transformation, again, we put quality as a culture. When we started our people transformation, we said, how do we really improve our culture for people processes? So as an organization, this is more of in our DNA. Today, we are on the technology journey, digital transformation journey, and we leverage our learnings and we kind of, you know, implemented those cultural changes. And again, it comes from top. So overall, like for example, I talked about Tech Fest, okay, the technology festivals. In our Piramal technology festivals, the entire leadership team makes sure that they participate, including a chairman, Mr. Ajay Piramal. Even if he's out traveling, but on the day of Tech Fest, he makes sure that, you know, he comes and, you know, and addresses the team that, yes, this is important for each one of us and we have to make it happen. So overall, it is definitely a top down.
Yeah, so thanks very much, sir. Please get your hands together, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Viral Gandhi.